Hey guys, it's Erica, and today I'm coming to you with my October favorites. It has been a while since I've done a favorites video, and that's just simply because I've been so busy with the move and the trip and all of that stuff. So I was so excited to come to you today with this video. I've got a lot of stuff to talk about. First thing up, let's start with food favorites. It's actually drink favorites, but I have a bottle of water here and I'm dying to put me a drink packet in it because I'm thirsty. So the first thing this month I want to talk to you about is this Crystal Light Pure. Have y'all seen this? And it says no artificial sweeteners, but it is sweetened with Truvia. And Truvia is made from the stevia leaf, so I do consider that still like an artificial sweetener. But it is better than most. I've tried two different flavors of this. This is the raspberry lemonade. I really do like it. And I also really love the mango tangerine. And then the next thing up is a coffee creamer. And Emily had mentioned this on her channel. It's the Coffee Mate Marshmallow Hot Cocoa. This is my second bottle. Like, I've already finished one whole bottle, and this one is down to here. I like plain coffees. I don't ever get like a flavored coffee. And I've mentioned this one before. This is the only one that I ever buy. It's the Folgers Morning Cafe. It's just a really good kind of medium roast everyday coffee. And I drink it all throughout the day, not just in the morning, but I like a plain coffee and a flavored coffee creamer. I normally do the white chocolate raspberry. Who makes that one? I don't know. I'll have to put it here. It's rare that I find a coffee creamer that I love, and this one is really good. You definitely taste the marshmallow and the hot cocoa, but it's not too chocolatey because I don't like chocolate, so definitely love this one, especially this time of year. So I guess my main favorite of the month is actually a skincare product. And Leslie, my friend that I went to Paris with, she works in a plastic surgery office, actually, but they do skincare. And I went to her office, and she actually, I bought this there, and this is by Zoe Medical. It's the same doctor who made Obagi. If you all have heard of that, it's like a medical grade skincare. And these are the Sebatrol Oil Control Pads. Guys, I love these. If you have really, really oily skin, these are wonderful. They contain like salicylic acid and glycolic acid, and I know witch hazel was one of the ingredients. I can't remember what all was in this. My skin is still oily with them, of course, right? Like, I don't think a stick of dynamite could get rid of my oil, but my face just feels so much smoother. The texture feels better, and it is really helping with my blackheads. I have a horrible time with blackheads. If you have oily skin, then you probably already know what it's like to have the large pores with the blackheads, right? It never ceases to amaze me how much a Biore strip gets out of my nose. But anyways, it's really helping with that, guys. I absolutely love these. It was $60 for 60 pads, and you're supposed to use 2 a day. So that would be $60 a month. Well, just in order to kind of like make them last a little bit longer, I only use these at night. If you have oily skin, definitely try those. But I do think you have to go somewhere to actually get kind of like a prescription for it. You just buy it there in the office. But this is not something you can buy just anywhere where it is medical grade skincare. My next favorite that I want to mention is the Sephora Playbox. I hands down think it is the best subscription service that I have ever got before. And one of the biggest reasons that I love it is for the skincare products that you get. Here is an Ulla Henriksen Sheer Transformation. This is an Algenist eye cream, and I had fingernail polish remover on my hands whenever I touched this, and it took all the writing off, but that's what's in this. And then this is a little Murad moisturizer. You know what? This might not have came in a play box. This might have came in an order I placed on the Murad site. I don't know. But anyways, I was just showing you like an example of some of the skincare that you get in there. And I have been lucky enough that all of the skincare that they have put in the play box works for me. And it keeps me from buying like skincare throughout the month, you know, like moisturizers and eye creams, because they keep me in a supply of them. So here lately, I've been using this Sheer Transformation of the Morning, the Algenist eye cream morning and night, and then the Murad cream at night, and it just really works great for me. I love the Sephora Playbox because the products that they send is always something really, really good. It's a $10 a month subscription, and you always get high-end stuff, you know, from brands that you know and love. I love that subscription service and love the skincare that you get in that subscription service as well. And I guess since I mentioned Sephora, I'll go ahead and mention some other stuff that I've picked up over the last month or so that I've been enjoying from there. When I do my makeup, 9 times out of 10, I do a really smoky, dramatic eye, and I do a very simple lip. That's kind of my signature look. I've never been one to like put on lip liner, then lipstick, then lip gloss, and have like a whole lip look. Like, I'm very simple when it comes to lips. Like, it's either lipstick or a gloss. That's how I roll. So, but I really do love a glossy lip. I'm not a liquid lipstick, matte lipstick kind of person. And guys, I love this lip gloss. It is the Marc Jacobs High Shine Gloss Lip Lacquer, and I even kept the little box like a good YouTuber. Now that you've seen it, I can throw it away, right? The color is Sugar Sugar, and I did hear about this from Jaclyn Hill. She was always like mentioning this lip gloss and talking about how pretty it is, and guys, it really is. Where it is Marc Jacobs, it is a little expensive. It was, I don't know, $28 or $29 I think for this lip gloss, but what I love about it, it's very opaque, you know, it covers your lips and you can wear it on its own and still get a really pretty lip look. It's glossy. It has some micro shimmers in there. Like, you feel nothing on your lips and you can't see shimmer or glitter on your lips whenever you're wearing this. But it does, if you look really close, have just some iridescent micro shimmers in there. Beautiful color, a true nude. And actually what this really reminds me of is the Flower Beauty lip gloss in Classic Nude. Holding them up together, this is actually the first time I've ever held them up together. The Flower one is definitely a couple of shades darker, but it's the formula that really reminds me of the Flower. I'm gonna go ahead and swatch them for you. The Flower is, it has no shimmers whatsoever in it. Just a really pretty nude, but it has full opacity, similar to this Marc Jacobs one. I've never swatched these side by side. Definitely a different shade, but as far as, yeah, they feel the same whenever you touch them. They look the same in terms of finish and gloss and opacity. So if you're not wanting to spend the money on the Marc Jacobs gloss, definitely check out the Flower Beauty ones. Both of these are great. And just in case you didn't know, Flower Beauty is available at Walmart. Another kind of all-in-one lip look that I've also been reaching for, the YSL Glossy Stain. This one's in number 15. I think it was Rose Vinyl. Guys, I love this. As much as I love gloss, I also love stains. I love anything with a staining property. They're just so handy. And this particular product is like the best of both worlds for me, right? Because it stains and it's a gloss. And it does stay on really well, but you do have to reapply. But you know, even though liquid lipsticks are not my favorite thing, and I'm not a huge fan of them, I do have several. And this new one that I picked up from Anastasia, I don't know, maybe 2 months ago, in Sad Girl, guys, such a pretty fall lipstick. Let me tell you why I love this one. Honey, it's kind of metallic. It's got these little shimmers in it. You can make this super dark and vampy, but if you kind of spread it out, it doesn't have to be too overwhelmingly dark. But guys, if you've never looked into the Sad Girl liquid lipstick, if you're like me and you like metallic, shimmery lip products, I do, I can't help it. Look at Sad Girl. It's such a special shade. Gorgeous. You can get this at Sephora. My number one fall blush is Narcissin. Like, that will never change. But another blush that I have picked up in the last couple of months that I've really been using again is MAC Melba. Guys, mine was so old, so I just went ahead and bought me a new one. This is a great blush year-round. It's not really pink, not really peach, not really brown, but a mixture of all three. And it goes with any look. Because like, if you've got a lot going on your eyes and, you know, or your lips, and you really don't know what blush to reach for, MAC Melba is one of those it goes with anything blushes. I love a pretty matte blush because I am oily. Great all year blush, but definitely great in the fall. I usually keep a couple different colors of Anastasia Brow Wizzes on hand, and it just so happened both colors of mine that I had on hand quit at the same time. Like that, I used them up in the same week. And so to change it up, I did buy the brow definer the last time. I have since bought a couple more brow wizzes, but you can see like the brow definer is the thicker tube and it is a triangle shape. I'm sure you can't see this, but it's a triangle shape and it just covers more territory whenever you're doing your brows, and it just makes everything so quick. I flat love this thing. Mine is in the shade medium brown. Y'all know I'm a NARS girl, honey. My favorite bronzer of life is Laguna. And sad to say, I'm no longer using this as my bronzer simply because it is so empty. And I just feel like I'm messing my brushes up, like ratting my brushes up, trying to get in there to get that last little bit of bronzer. So I am using the rest of this for like eyeshadow, like a transition shade. But I did pull out my Marc Jacobs Omega Bronze in Tantric. I actually do love this bronzer. And I love big palettes of bronzer that I can like use a big fluffy brush in. And compared to Laguna, this is more warm, but not bad. It's completely matte. It looks very natural on the skin. And I absolutely love this bronzer. I don't think it gets enough credit in the beauty world. As far as eyeshadow goes this month, I've really been busy and been doing a whole lot. And when I'm busy and I just want to do my makeup and go, and I know it's going to look good. Number one, hands down, still to this day, is the Stila Eyes Are the Window palette in Seoul. Guys, how many times have I talked about this palette? If there was ever an eyeshadow palette made for me, this would be it. It's everything that I need. I use Stila Kitten as a tear duct highlight every single time I put on makeup. Gorgeous brow on highlight, matte, mid-tone crease shades, both warm and cool. Beautiful metallic shimmery lid shades, a matte dark brown, and a matte black to really deepen things up. This is everything that I need. I will be heartbroken if they ever get rid of this palette. And then another shadow that I've actually really been loving is this little CoverGirl quad. And this is in, I think it was called Vivid Greens. It's ripped on the back, I don't know. But it's this one shade actually in the whole palette. This first one, this really kind of dark burgundy plum. Guys, I love shadows like this. And my favorite way to do it, similar to what I'm doing today, I take any kind of orange eyeshadow. This is the Too Faced Peanut Butter and Jelly palette. Peanut Butter and Nuts About You are both gorgeous orange eyeshadows, like really warm brown eyeshadows. Blend those out all up in your crease and then pop this kind of like really dark plummy burgundy shade on your lid and on that lower lash line. Gorgeous. And then I think as far as beauty favorites go, my last favorites are what I wear on my lashes. I got a couple of these Dior Show Maximizer 3D lash primers with, I know one came with a Sephora order and I think one came with a Nordstrom order. I love this. I'm really not a huge lash primer person, so I can't really compare this to a lot of other things because I've simply not tried a whole lot. But what I noticed with this one, you know, I guess it does work in giving you some length and volume too, but it seems to really keep these lower lashes from smudging down here. At least I think so. If you have long lower lashes and they touch your cheek, then you know exactly what I'm talking about. That horrible like smudging that you get underneath your eyes. I can't stand it. I still get some of it. But that really does seem to help kind of lock my mascaras into place. I mentioned in one of my other videos that my cousin Whitney's dad actually had a heart attack. And I went to the hospital a couple days with her. And she stayed here for a little over a week. And we were at the hospital one day. And she was like, your eyelashes look fake. And she was like, what are you wearing? Well, I don't remember if I had this on. I think I might have. I don't know. But honey, a great mascara pairing. The Essence Lash Princess. My friend Kate that I met here on YouTube. Hi, Kate. She sent me this whenever Granny had passed away. And I love this mascara. Like, this totally, totally takes the place as my number one drugstore mascara. Granted, you can't really get Essence at a lot of drugstores. But you can get it at Ulta. And I think this bad boy is about $4. Totally trumps the Maybelline The Rocket. That was my favorite for so long. love this mascara. So what I do is I put on a layer of this, a layer of this, and then I top it really quick with just a little bit of the Too Faced Better Than Sex. Beautiful lashes. And so the last things I'm going to talk to you about are some fashion favorites. Fall fashion favorites, I guess, that I've been really enjoying this year. It's been a very warm fall here in Kentucky, and I'm sorry. You know, at night it gets down to, say, 40 degrees. Well, by the evening time during the day, it's like 78, 80 degrees. And the last thing I'm going to do is put on, like, knee boots and a big honking sweater and blanket scarf and go traipsing around out here in the heat. Like, no, I can't do that. But that being said, you know, I still want to dress in fall attire and have like a fall look. So here are the things that I have been wearing for these warm fall days that still let me be in the fall spirit, but they don't like totally burn me up, right? I have worn some knee boots, you know, leather riding boots, whatever. And I'll come home and take those off in the evening and I can feel the heat like releasing from my legs, right? That is so miserable. Guys, the perfect balance. Get you some ankle boots. These are Forever 21. I'm sure they don't have these. I got these a couple years ago. They might have something similar to it on their site. I've not looked. I can tell you almost every brand out there makes a leather ankle boot. But get you one with some like bling on the side. I know Chloe makes a pair of these. If you have the money, honey, I don't. I love how these are pointy toed and just kind of edgy and like a rocker chick would wear these, right? My favorite way to wear them is with a moto style jacket. I have like a lightweight one that I got from Target. But love these shoes. And so you get the boot and the edginess of the boot and the fall feel, but you really don't get burnt up. And again, these are Forever 21. I got them in Las Vegas at the Forever 21 at the fashion show mall there. They are genuine leather. So these were like, I don't know, $80, $90. But I did get them on sale. I don't remember for how much. But it just says Forever 21 collection. But these were actually genuine leather. These should last for like years. I got me a little stack of clothes here I'm going to talk about. I'm going to scoot back, which means I'll probably be out of frame. But my clothes should be in frame. So the first thing I guess I'll mention are blouses. You know, a blouse is kind of a slinkier material, but you know, you have the long sleeve, and if you want to, if it's warm, you can use the tab. If it's not, like, let that tab out and have the long sleeve. And then, you know, you can always throw on like a scarf with it, or a lightweight vest, or a lightweight jacket, and it's just a great transition piece into fall. This one actually came from JCPenney, and it has the lace-up detailing here at the neck, which is so popular right now. I've actually got another piece here that's lace-up. This one was really affordable. I love the color. It's like a really pretty royal blue with a little bit of kind of a grape undertone in it. But for kind of trendy items, like, say, this lace-up, you know, neck. I don't know how long that's going to be in style. For something like that, I just get something really affordable, like this from JCPenney. I think it was $20 or $30. And then I also got this lace-up top from Forever 21. It's like a boxy style sweatshirt, but just super affordable and kind of on trend. A color scheme that I've really been enjoying lately are like basically your food colors, right? Like wine and eggplant and mustard. I love colors like that during the fall. And this is a blouse that I got from Target. It is by Mossimo. And it does have the tabs on the sleeve. So if it's cool, I can wear the sleeve long. If it's hot, I can roll this up. But again, just that lightweight, kind of silky blouse material. And then another thing that I always really love is a cardigan. I have the really pretty kind of wine eggplant shade from Mossimo. This is from Target. This one, I'm not for sure where it came from because I cut the tag out. Is anybody else super sensitive to tags like I am? Like, they aggravate me to death. They eat my skin up. But just really pretty kind of boyfriend style cardigan in that mustard. And then this one is a long kind of cream off-white shade one. And this is actually from Walmart. It's by the brand White Stag. And I love this one. And so with those, I'll just pair some kind of a shell. This is from Walmart. Do I ever buy these? They're like $5. They're from Faded Glory. And it's this kind of like slinky material. What is this? Rayon? Polyester. And they're great to wear like under your cardigans. And then I got this really pretty kind of mustard colored one from Nordstrom. This is from the brand Lush. I wore this when I was in London. And so my favorite way to accessorize kind of any of these, the blouses, the cardigans with the shells, is with a really pretty scarf. And I found this one from Target, and it's got kind of all those colors in it. I don't know if you can see it. The burgundy color is a little bit, it's showing a little more red on camera. It's actually more of an eggplant color in person. And then it's got the really pretty kind of goldish mustard, the off-white. And while this is kind of a blanket scarf, it's not one of those really big kind of cumbersome ones that you're like, they choke me to death. It has to be dead of winter for me to wear a blanket scarf. Like, what happened to just regular scarves? I went to Target the other day and I was like, they have no just plain scarves. They were all like big, fluffy, thick blanket scarves. No, I cannot do it. But they had this really light and thin for a blanket scarf. So it's really, really doable. Finding a scarf in this color scheme, the eggplant, wine, cream, mustard, that's actually very hard. I actually ordered one from Nordstrom. It was by the brand BP, and it was only like maybe $30. Guys, it was huge and stiff, and I mean, I tried every way in this world to like tie it, and I can tie a scarf pretty good. No. I mean, I was like, I couldn't even turn my head. It was terrible. Love this one from Target. And then my number one favorite for fall, honey, is and will always be the plaid flannel shirt. Mine, my favorite ones come from Old Navy. And mentioning these things, I'm not saying like run out and get the exact same shirt that I'm talking about in the exact same print. You know, I'm just wanting you to see the kind of style of things that I'm wearing, and then you can use what you have. Or, you know, if you're looking to purchase any of these things, you could buy them, but I'm not saying run out and buy these exact pieces. That's not what I'm saying. Lightweight blouses that have the tab where you can have a long sleeve or a 3/4 sleeve, plaid flannel shirts, you know, cardigans with tank tops, that kind of thing, you know, pretty scarves. And then the other thing I wanted to mention was this beautiful vest. I got this a couple years ago from Old Navy, and I know it was called their barn vest, but it's very thin. Like, it's not one of those big poofy puffer down vest or whatever. And it's just really sleek, very thin. I love the gold hardware on it, and it's just, it goes with anything. My favorite way to wear this is over top of a plaid shirt. And throw on a pair of boots, pair of skinny jeans, one of these, and see how it matches like every print. Say it was a cold night at an apple orchard or a pumpkin patch or a haunted hayride or whatever it is you were wanting to go and do. You could throw on a blanket scarf with that, you know, or a regular scarf, you know, a solid color scarf with those, and it just looks so pretty. But yeah, guys, I think that does it for my October favorites. I'm sure there was probably more stuff I could be talking about, but this was basically it. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. And if you have any requests for a video, leave it down below and I'll try to do it, okay? Have a great week, a great weekend, and I will see you all soon.